I'm gonna just be honest, this was the greatest interview of all time.
This is Donovan Cockley from Hot Water.
Hi, I'm Carrie Miller.
Hey, I'm Ross from Prime Circle.
Love, love, love RTL.
My new addiction.
Let me not just talk about it. Let me show you in the back of the window where I'm at.
Cabinet has decided to place the entire country on alert level 2.
No, thank you for getting me out of bed this morning.
Informative.
Relevant.
Diverse. Interactive.
So educational.
Fantastic.
Super fulfilling.
I think most of the time in South Africa, certainly provincial cricket, they might as well play because there's no spectators going to watch anyone.
They're hugging, shaking of hands, and kissing is a thing of the past.
And then overnight into Thursday, we're expecting that cold front to spread a shower into most...
The playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining. And entertaining.
They wanted radio people because radio people can basically talk shit when things go wrong.
A sight that just a few weeks ago seemed scarcely possible. Eden Park is back in business, a capacity...
No, but seriously, on a serious note, I think I actually swiped right from the one day when I saw you. I
didn't know. No, you didn't.
But you wouldn't know.
And I love Chris. If I tell you, I didn't wear a bra, that was so good.
Splashdown.
As you can see on your screen, we have visual confirmation for Splashdown.
You guys are the lifeblood of what's left of this music industry.
And of course, Noel Johnson.
We love your sexy legs.
Especially because of Noel Johnson. Jeez, that man is sexy.
Thank God for RTL SA.
You are a star.
RTL SA.
Home of legends. Legends.
Caban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Caban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.caban.co.za for more information. Caban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. This is your top three on RTL SA.
Brought to you by Creative Design and Print. For all your specialized printing requirements, contact Lauren on 072-114-0329 or lauren.creativedesign@gmail.com.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTL SA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTL SA.
Playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Bass music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining.
RTL is
RTL.
You're listening to RTL SA.
You're listening to RTL SA.
RTL.
Thursday, the 9th of September, 2021. 2 days time, 20 years ago, the Twin Towers were flown into and came tumbling to the ground, which started a 20-year insurgency into the Middle East by the United States, which has just ended. Now, recently, the Taliban have taken back over Afghanistan. They were in power of Afghanistan when all this happened back in 2001. And they provided safe harbor for Al-Qaeda, who was then headed by Osama bin Laden at that time. What's going to happen next? Because the old guard has stepped back in. Where's Al-Qaeda? We haven't mentioned their name for a while. Where did they come from? Are they still around today? Are they still functional? We find out. We have a closer look. We look at the history. We look at what's going on now and whether or not they are in fact going to play a role in future world politics. We're not sure. But I'll tell you more about that in the main story a little later. Right now, let's get into your news headlines. Let's see what's happening in the weather as well. That brought to you by the SABC.
Right, top story now. The United Nations chief has slammed the inequity around COVID-19 vaccine distribution globally and says he will use the upcoming UN General Assembly to ring the alarm bell. The 76th session of the General Assembly kicks off next week. Guterres wasted no time in criticizing what he called a dramatic inequity around vaccine availability globally. With over 5 billion doses administered, only 2% have gone to Africa. The UN chief says we cannot defeat COVID-19 because of egoism and the inequity in the distribution of vaccines. The National Institute for Communicable Diseases, meanwhile, says another 253 people have died from COVID-19 related complications in the latest report. This brings the overall death toll to 84,152. More than 7,000 new cases were also recorded. Meanwhile, Deputy President David Mabuse is expected to lead the Interministerial Committee on COVID-19 vaccine rollout outreach in the Northwest Province this morning. A National Commissioner of Correctional Services, Arthur Fraser, stands by his decision to release the former head of state, Jacob Zuma, on medical parole. In an interview on SABC News last night, Fraser said the medical parole of the former president was both procedurally sound and legal. Fraser dismissed allegations that he overrode the recommendations of the Medical Parole Advisory Board when he authorized the release of Zuma. Local government elections are set to take place on the 1st of November, and this is the first time in the country's history that the polls will open on a Monday. Minister of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs, Dr. Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma, announced the date after the Constitutional Court order declared the proclamation of the 27th of October as invalid and unconstitutional.
Very good morning to you. Let's get you a quick weather update. We are expecting clear skies over the western parts of the country, but partly cloudy over the central and eastern parts, where we are starting off with early morning fog patches along the escarpment of Limpopo and Mpumalanga. That can lead to visibility being reduced to less than a kilometer in places. South African Weather Service warning of high fire danger conditions over the western interior, so please do take caution as runaway fault fires are possible. In terms of our daytime temperatures, seeing fairly cool to warm conditions across most parts of the country. Sutherland will peak at 25 today, Cape Town expecting 20. A cool day along the coastal regions, 21 in George, Kabega and East London peaking at 20. Port St. John's a maximum of 20, Durban 23, and as you move over the interior of KwaZulu-Natal, Pietermaritzburg and Ladysmith both reaching 21. It is a warm day forecast in Bloemfontein and Kimberley, with those partly cloudy skies, 27 is your maximum. Tomorrow now seeing a clearing over the central regions as well, just partly cloudy over the northeastern part, starting off with light precipitation over the low veld of Limpopo and Mpumalanga. That is a 30% chance. Temperatures remaining cool over KwaZulu-Natal. The rest of the country, however, seeing those warm conditions. Then into the weekend on Saturday, seeing partly cloudy skies over the northeastern parts, that is Mpumalanga, northern parts of KwaZulu-Natal, as well as in places over Limpopo. It will be clear over the central regions, where we are expecting cool to warm conditions, but a band of of isolated showers and rain expected along the southwestern coastline and the adjacent interior. That's your weather. Do stay tuned.
So it's Throwback Thursday today, and we will throw back in the second hour of the show, in the beginning of the second hour of the show, to some music that really shaped our lives and who we are today. Your top three, brought to you by Creative Design and Print, is Carrie's selection today. Very nice selection coming your way. Your Power Play Trivia, brought to you by Bev Miller, coming up a little bit. And the question relates to beer. Yesterday was Beer Lovers Today. Day, and today we're going to talk a little bit about beer. We look at today in history as well. Your burning topic, where were you? Now, there's a reason I'm doing this, because obviously tomorrow we don't have burning topic because it's Bad Joke Friday. So I thought maybe in today's burning topic, we should talk about it, because on Saturday, it is the 20-year anniversary since the Twin Towers, since 9/11. Okay. Where were you on that day? What were you up to? I can still vividly remember where I was, what time it was, what I was doing when all of that happened in the United States. So send me your comments via voice note on 0641340020, and I will play those comments back a little later in the show. Days of the year, it is Teddy Bear Day. So get yourself a little teddy bear if you don't have one, and give it a little squeeze. Wiener Schnitzel Day. Yes, crumbed meat that's been slapped flat. Love it. It's awesome. It is also Otis Redding Day in a lot of places in the world, because he was born on this day back in 1941. Which brings me to, in other news, we'll have a look at a little bit of his life story, because he's one of the very few artists that had a number one hit after his death. And wrapping it up, Wonderful Weirdos Day. It is Wonderful Weirdos Day. It's a day where you appreciate the weird people in your life, but more importantly, appreciate and embrace your inner weirdo-ness. There we go.
Cabana Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Cabana offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.cabana.co.za for more information. Cabana Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
You're listening to RTLSA. I want to be on lockdown with Noel Johnson.
You're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're going to party it up listening to Noel Johnson.
As I was saying, you're listening to my mate, Noel Johnson.
RTLSA is proudly brought to you by Caban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. Visit www.cabancapital.co for more information.
RTLSA.
Liam Payne and Rita Ora for you on RTLSA. It's time to get into your Power Play Trivia.
Time to test your knowledge with Power Play Trivia.
And like I said, your Power Play Trivia, the question today relates to beer. Okay, and the question I ask is, where did Heineken beer originate? Where did Heineken beer originate? And they are the second largest brewer in the world. But where did they come from? Let's see if you know that answer. Send me your answer to WhatsApp on 064-134-0020. Let's see if you can figure this one out. I'm dying to know if you can.
I'm going to just be honest. This was the greatest interview of all time.
This is Donovan Copley from Hot Water.
I am Carrie Miller.
Hey, I'm Ross from Prime Circle.
Love, love, love RTL.
My new addiction.
Let me not just talk about it. Let me show you in the back of the window where I'm at.
Cabinet has decided to place the entire country on alert level 2.
No, thank you for getting me out of bed this morning.
Informative.
Relevant.
Diverse. Interactive.
So educational.
Fantastic. Super fulfilling.
I think most of the time in South Africa, certainly provincial cricket, they might as well play because there's no spectators going to watch anyone.
They're hugging, shaking of hands, and kissing. Is a thing of the past.
And then overnight into Thursday, we're expecting that cold front to spread showers into most.
The playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining. And entertaining.
They wanted radio people because radio people can basically talk shit when things go wrong.
A sight that just a few weeks ago seemed scarcely possible. Eden Park is back in business, a capacity.
No, but seriously, on a serious note, I think I actually swiped right from the one day when I saw you. I don't know.
No, you didn't.
But you wouldn't know.
And I love Chris. If I tell you, I didn't wear a bra, that was so good.
Splashdown.
As you can see on your screen, we have visual confirmation for Splashdown.
I will try to fix you.
You guys are the lifeblood of what's left of this music industry.
And of course, Noel Johnson.
We love your sexy legs.
Especially because of Noel Johnson. Jeez, that man is sexy.
Thank God for RTLSA.
You are a star.
RTLSA.
Home of legends. Legends.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as
300 Rand per week.
Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
Right, it's time to have a look at today in history. Let's see what happened. I told you already Otis Redding was born in 1941, but let's see what else happened on this day.
September 9th, 1971. Inmates seize control of the Attica Correctional Facility in upstate New York. After a four-day siege, police and guards storm the maximum security prison near Buffalo. The ordeal leaves 32 inmates and 11 prison employees dead, with hundreds more wounded. 1976. Mao Zedong, founding leader of Communist China, dies in Beijing at age 82 after years of tumultuous and autocratic rule. Under Mao's successors, China embraces free market reforms, becoming one of the world's fastest-growing economies. 1956. A milestone in early rock and roll, Elvis Presley makes the first of three celebrated TV appearances on The Ed Sullivan Show on CBS. And 1941. Otis Redding, the soul singer and songwriter, is born in Dawson, Georgia. Among his songs, Respect, best known as a hit for Aretha Franklin, Try a Little Tenderness, and Sitting on the Dock of the Bay. Today in history, September 9th, Carlotta Bradley, The Associated Press.
RTLSA.
Amy MacDonald, released in 2007, Mr. Rock and Roll. Before that, Banners, Someone to You, and Anastasia, I'm Out of Love, Bob's future ex-wife. Self-proclaimed, no doubt. I'm sure Anastasia has no idea that she is going to be Bob's future ex-wife. Anyway, we're going to get into the main story now. We're going to talk about Al-Qaeda. And the reason we're talking about Al-Qaeda is because the Taliban have bought in the old guard. Now that they've taken over Afghanistan, they've bought in the old guard, the same guys that were in power back in 2001. And they were harboring Al-Qaeda in Afghanistan. We haven't heard much about Al-Qaeda in recent times, but now we have to ask ourselves, now with the Taliban back in power, are the Al-Qaeda people still about? What are they up to? I don't know. Let's find out on the other side of this.
Caban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Caban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.caban.co.za for more information. Caban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic, Bad Joke Friday, in other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTL SA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za. It's time to mass debate on RTL SA.
You're listening to RTLSA. You're listening to RTLSA.
Right, in the burning topic today, I asked you where you were and what you were doing on the 11th of September, 2001, obviously when the World Trade Center had planes flown into it and world politics changed in an instant. Where were you? What were you up to? Send me your comments via voice notes on 064-134-0020. I asked that question today specifically because obviously, tomorrow there is no burning topic with Bad Joke Friday. And Saturday is the 20-year anniversary of that event. So send me your comments via voice notes. Al-Qaeda was behind those attacks. Where are they now? What are they doing? Are they still around? Are they going to be a problem in the future now that Afghanistan is under Taliban rule again? Let's find out.
Let's talk about Al-Qaeda. 9/11 was the first time that a lot of people had heard of them and their leader, Osama bin Laden.
There's only one group that has ever indicated that it has this kind of ability, and that's Osama bin Laden.
Nearly 3,000 people were killed, and overnight, Osama bin Laden became the world's most wanted man.
I want justice. There's an old poster out west, as I recall, that said, wanted, dead or alive.
It took 10 years for the U.S. to track him down and kill him. But today, the group he created is still very much alive.
A very fearsome kind of organization, one that still has resilience.
So 20 years after 9/11, how has Al-Qaeda changed? What are they trying to achieve? And what could the Taliban takeover of Afghanistan mean for them? Al-Qaeda has been around since the late 1980s. U.S. intelligence had their eye on them way before 9/11 because they'd been linked to several attacks, including a 1992 bombing at a hotel in Yemen, a truck bomb that blew up at the World Trade Center, simultaneous attacks on American embassies in Tanzania and Kenya, and the bombing of a U.S. Navy destroyer. So what was driving Al-Qaeda? Well, to understand that, we have to understand Osama bin Laden. He was born in Saudi Arabia and came from a wealthy family that ran one of the biggest construction companies in the Middle East. In the 1980s, bin Laden went to Afghanistan to join the fight against the Soviet occupation. He styled himself as a devout Muslim who had a duty to defend other Muslims from a foreign occupying power. And in 1988, he established Al-Qaeda, using his millions to fund and recruit fighters for the cause. After the Soviets withdrew from Afghanistan in 1989, bin Laden's mission shifted to focus on the US. And the first Gulf War was a catalyst. Iraq had invaded Kuwait, the US came to Kuwait's defense, and in the process stationed thousands of US soldiers in Saudi Arabia. And as with the Soviets in Afghanistan, bin Laden saw the U.S. as a foreign power in Muslim lands.
There was a larger philosophy around bringing down the idea of the West touching any, quote, Muslim soil.
He felt that attacking the United States directly was important.
The question was, how would he do it? Well, by 1996, the Taliban had seized power in Afghanistan, and it became clear they would provide some kind of sanctuary for bin Laden to build up his group.
He had created a mini army of sorts in Afghanistan. He created these sprawling training camps in which he was training thousands of foreign fighters.
So the late 90s was a time that Al-Qaeda, tucked away in Afghanistan, was able to grow and plan attacks, including 9/11.
Somewhere tonight, terrorists are celebrating the apocalyptic destruction that has killed so many and forever changed America and its largest city.
The only question is, what would be, in American terms at least, proportionate retaliation for this type of event?
Our war on terror begins with Al-Qaeda, but it does not end there. It will not end until every terrorist group of global reach has been found, stopped, and defeated.
That so-called war on terror led to the invasion of Afghanistan by the US and UK, with several other countries joining a bit later. President Bush also used it to justify the US invasion of Iraq in 2003, even though Iraq had no connection to 9/11. Over the next few years, many top members of Al-Qaeda were killed, mostly by US drone strikes, but Al-Qaeda was still a threat. And it was still able to attract new recruits for lots of reasons. One of them was the growth of the internet, which helped them spread their message further and faster. And it's been argued that abuses committed by the US and others in the name of the war on terror also ended up pushing more people towards them. Things like the torture at the Abu Ghraib prison in Iraq and the indefinite carceration without charge or trial of hundreds of detainees at Guantanamo Bay.
The war on terror has been a major determinant of rising anger and even some desperation among hundreds of millions of citizens around the Middle East and South Asia. Ordinary citizens suddenly die because a missile comes out of the sky and kills them, and they know that where this missile came from. And that breeds just incredible anger.
In the years after 9/11, there were more plots and attacks by Al-Qaeda and those they inspired, like the Bali bombing, the Madrid train attack, London 7/7, and the Charlie Hebdo shootings in Paris. But not all these happened under Osama bin Laden, because by 2011, he was dead. After a 10-year manhunt, the US found him and killed him in Pakistan.
We have cut off their head, and we will ultimately defeat them.
The killing of Osama bin Laden was a big blow to Al-Qaeda. He was replaced by Ayman al-Zawahiri, an Egyptian who had been a top member of Al-Qaeda since the late 90s. But he's no bin Laden.
He is someone who is seen as having almost no charisma, as a result, far less inspiring.
You know, he's seen, perceived as a pedantic uncle who goes on these long, rambling speeches.
There have been various reports of al-Zawahiri being killed, But most experts believe he's still alive, hiding out somewhere in Afghanistan with a $25 million bounty on his head. Al-Qaeda's leadership is under constant pressure from a huge international counterterrorism effort. It's made it harder for the group to plan attacks on the same scale as 9/11. But Al-Qaeda has adapted.
What it represents today is a resilient organization that has the capacity to bring in, like a magnet, other types of groups that kind of go with their narratives. They have staying power.
So Al-Qaeda now has a network of affiliates around the world. Aside from Afghanistan and Pakistan, there are groups in different parts of Africa, like Al-Shabaab in Somalia and Al-Qaeda in the Islamic Maghreb in Algeria, Libya, and Tunisia. There's another group in Mali. In South Asia, it's been active in places like India and Bangladesh. And in the Middle East, Al-Qaeda has taken advantage of the chaos caused by wars in Iraq, Syria, and Yemen, developing branches in all those countries. The one in Iraq actually split off and became ISIL. They became a big rival of Al-Qaeda's.
Al-Qaeda would very much like ISIS to sort of go away or to demobilize as quickly as possible.
But are Al-Qaeda about to get a boost? The Taliban has taken over Afghanistan again. And last time around, they helped Al-Qaeda. This time, they say it'll be different. But can the Taliban be trusted when it comes to Al-Qaeda?
The Taliban made similar commitments in the pre-9/11 era as well. We now know that the US government approached the Taliban around 30 times, asking them to do something about bin Laden and Al-Qaeda, to not host Al-Qaeda. And still 9/11 happened. Even now, they're not coming clean on the current status of their relationship with Al-Qaeda.
Some people, though, would argue that Al-Qaeda's biggest weapon has always been and continues to be something more powerful and elusive than men with guns.
He unleashed a ripple effect that impacted the way societies think about themselves. Today, 20 years afterwards, this us versus them has exploded in a way that we couldn't have imagined.
But actions by the US and its allies since 9/11 have also created a ripple effect.
If you talk to a poor farmer in rural Yemen or Pakistan or Syria, whose house was destroyed and 10 members of his family were killed by a drone fired by the US or foreign groups fighting the terror groups, the legacy of bin Laden Al-Qaeda will be a positive one. People say, well, somebody stood up for us. Somebody tried to fight back.
Many of the ideas that bin Laden put forward are much more mainstream than they were 20 years ago. And one of the most important is the idea that the West is at war with the Muslim world.
And now that the last US soldier has left Afghanistan, the Taliban are celebrating what they see as a victory in that war. And so it would seem, are Al-Qaeda.
Al-Qaeda's ecosystem in particular are electrified by the return of the Taliban, by the fact that the Taliban has prevailed against the United States. They see it as their own victory because they have supported, they've seen the Taliban's insurgency against the US as a key component of their platform.
20 years after 9/11, the world has changed and Al-Qaeda has changed. But after all this time, the question of what Al-Qaeda might do next is probably as important as it ever was.
Yeah, exactly. Although the Taliban say they will not harbor or allow anybody within Afghanistan to operate as terrorists against other people, you never know. They're keeping their cards very close to their chest at the moment with regard to that. And Al-Qaeda will feel safer now that US troops are gone and stuff like that. And like they spoke about, in the 90s, they regrouped. They built their army. I'm not saying there's going to be an attack anytime soon, and heaven forbid, I hope there isn't an attack ever. But it's not likely that Al-Qaeda are just going to chill out in the mountains and not do anything. It's just not within their mandate, so to say. So we'll have to see what happens. Let's hope there's world peace. But if you have to look at history, you have to ask yourself the question, is it really possible, as long as the United States is involved in international affairs, you know, you always have opposition coming from the Islam State with regards to that. And I mean, ISIS is another one. Let's see. Al-Qaeda is still around. Let's see what happens next.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTL SA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064 134 0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za. It's time to mass debate on RTL SA.
Playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining.
RTL. RTL.
RTL. You're listening to RTL SA.
This is your top three on RTLSA.
Brought to you by Creative Design and Print. For all your specialized printing requirements, contact Lauren on 072 114 0329 or lauren.creativedesign@gmail.com.
You ask for it, we play it. Your top three on RTLSA.
It's Carrie's selection on your top three today, brought to you by Creative Design and Print. Sarah Bareilles with Love Song, before that Taylor Swift with Willow, and Sketchy Bongo featuring Carl Deutsch, and Back to the Beach, starting it all off right here on RTLSA.
This is your top three on RTLSA.
Brought to you by Creative Design and Print. For all your specialized printing requirements, contact Lauren on 072 114 0329 or lauren.creativedesign@gmail.com. Right, coming up in the next hour of the show, in the beginning of the hour, we throw back to music that has shaped our lives and influenced us and been a part of us coming to the point we are today. So in a long way round, I said cool music from the past. That's what we're going to play for a little bit in the beginning. And then we're going to have a look at Otis Redding. Otis Redding was born today in 1941, and of course, unfortunately, at the age of 26, died in a horrible aeroplane crash. But he had a big number one hit after he passed away, and very few people get that right. Yeah, you get a little bit of a sympathy bump in your ratings and stuff like that normally, but you don't have a smash hit normally after you die, and in this case he did. So we have a look at the man who they credit as being the front runner in soul music back in the day, and his career was relatively short because obviously he died in the aeroplane crash, and it only spanned over like 3 or 4 years that he was at the top before he died. So we have a look at that a little later. We still got your Power Play trivia question, which is, where did Heineken beer originate? Where did Heineken originate? Send your answers via WhatsApp on 064-134-0020. And then the burning topic, brought to you by Cheryl and Kirsten Morrigan. Where were you and what were you doing on the 9th? Oh, on 9-11. On the 11th of the 9th. 11th of September 2001. When planes were used as missiles and launched into the World Trade Center. I'm really twisting my tongue here. Anyway, where were you, what were you doing when that was going down? Because that was a moment that changed the world forever. Send me your comments via voice note on 064-134-0020.
Kabana Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Kabana offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.kaban.co.za for more information. Kaban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
You're listening to RTLSA.
I want to be on lockdown with Noel Johnson.
You're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're going to party it up listening to Noel Johnson.
As I was saying, you're listening to my mate, Noel Johnson.
A ray from the grave.
It's
a blast from the past.
Throwback Thursday at its best. Silver Pozzoli with Around My Dreams, Touch and Go, Would You Go to Bed With Me? And then Talking Heads with We're on the Road to Nowhere. Man, what a blast from the past. Love it. Right, we're going to get into the Otis Redding piece in just a little bit. And it's not a very long piece, but it's just a little background, a little life of his story, and more particular about the song that became a number one hit after he died. We get into that on the other side of this.
I'm gonna just be honest, this was the greatest interview of all time.
This is Donovan Copley from Hot Water.
I am Carrie Miller.
Hey, I'm Ross from Prime Circle.
Love RTL.
My new addiction.
Let me not just talk about it. Let me show you in the back of the window where I'm at.
Cabinet has decided to place the entire country on alert level 2.
No, thank you for getting me out of bed this morning.
Informative.
Relevant.
Diverse.
Interactive.
So educational.
Fantastic. Super fulfilling.
I think most of the time in South Africa, certainly provincial cricket, they might as well play because there's no spectators going to watch anyone.
They're hugging, shaking of hands, and kissing is a thing of the past.
And then overnight into Thursday, we're expecting that cold front to spread showers into most.
The playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining.
And entertaining.
They wanted radio people because radio people can basically talk shit when things go wrong.
A sight that just a few weeks ago seemed scarcely possible. Eden Park is back in business, a capacity.
No, but seriously, on a serious note, I think I actually swiped right from the one day when I saw you. I don't know.
No, you didn't.
But you wouldn't know.
And I love dress. If I tell you, I didn't wear a bra, that was so good.
Splashdown.
As you can see on your screen, we have visual confirmation for Splashdown.
I will try to fix you.
You guys are the lifeblood of what's left of this music industry.
And of course, Noel Johnson.
We love your sexy legs.
Especially because of Noel Johnson. Jeez, that man is sexy.
Thank God for RTLSA.
You are a star.
RTLSA.
Home of legends.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news. Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064 134 0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
You're listening to RTLSA.
Yeah, my continuity director just sent me a voice note.
Otis Redding, the life of his story. Shouldn't be the story of life.
you clonk on bubbles. Did I say that? I apologize profusely for saying that. Getting my English all twisted. Anyway, yeah, the story of his life is what I meant to say. Thank you, Bob, for picking that up for me and sorting that out and calling me a plonker in the same breath. But we are, of course, talking about Otis Redding and the story of his life. Yeah, let's have a look at that.
You know, only a few performers have reached number one with a single after their deaths. John Lennon and Janis Joplin, for example. But the first person to do it in the U.S. was the dynamic Otis Redding. Redding died in a plane crash on December 10th, 1967 in Lake Monona in Madison, Wisconsin. He was only 26 years old. Also killed four members of his backing band, the Barquets, an assistant, and the pilot. Ben Cauley, the Barquets' 20-year-old trumpet player and singer, was the only one of eight people on board to survive the crash. So, what's the story behind the song, Sittin' on the Dock of the Bay? Redding played the Monterey Pop Festival in June 1967. He knew it was a big deal, but he didn't know what the response from the crowd would be. They loved him. After the show, he flew home to his ranch in Macon, Georgia, to share some great news with his wife, Zelda. He told her, "I got a new audience." Redding rested for a few weeks, and in August 1967, he returned to San Francisco to perform at a jazz club. When he was mobbed by female fans at his hotel, the promoter, Bill Graham, told him, "You can stay on my houseboat in Sausalito." Redding spent his days quietly looking at the water. He could relax and write songs. One day, he picked up his guitar and wrote a new song that began, "Sittin' in the morning sun, I'll be sittin' when the evening comes." That fall, Redding stopped touring because he required surgery to move polyps from his vocal cords. After healing from his surgery, in November 1967, Redding flew into the Memphis airport and called his friend Steve Cropper, who was the backing guitarist for Booker T and the MGs, aka the Stax House Band. He called Cropper to make sure he was going to be at the studio. When Redding arrived, he ran into the studio and told Cropper, "Get your guitar," as he pronounced it, "I got a hit." They sat and hammered out the song. Cropper added the line, "I left my home in Georgia," because he wanted to make it personal. Otis was born in Dawson and lived in Macon. Cropper says, "I wrote the second verse, wrote the bridge, helped on the third verse, and arranged it." He says, "Ships, that's what I'm thinking. San Francisco, Frisco Bay, you know, ships going under the Golden Gate Bridge." That was not what he was talking about. He was talking about the ferries that went across to Oakland to Sausalito. You know, when a ferry comes to park and let people off in their cars, they kind of roll in. And when they do that, they push up a big wave on the bank. So a ferry was a ship in his mind. So they finished writing and go in to record. Redding thought it needed background, and Cropper agreed with it. The Staple Singers earlier on had been signed to Stax, and Cropper had been working with them and suggested that they be on the record, but it never happened. The whistling toward the end of the song has been the subject of a lot of discussion. Cropper says he left space at the end of the song for Redding to add extra vocals in case he wanted to do it at a later date. During this session, Redding forgot what he wanted to sing and whistled instead. Engineer Ron Capone said jokingly he wasn't going to make it as a whistler. After three takes, he nailed it. Later, gossip started whirling that Redding's whistling wasn't sufficient and that Cropper hired musician Sam Bluesman Taylor to do a stronger take. Cropper denies that and says, "I don't even know where that story came from." Sitting on the Dock of the Bay was recorded 2 weeks before Otis's death. Cropper played acoustic guitar on the session, but Otis never heard the electric guitar because Cropper overdubbed it on a Friday afternoon and Redding died in the plane crash Sunday morning. Plus, he never heard the ocean waves and the seagulls on the record. After Redding's death, Cropper gets a call from Atlantic Records saying they had to have a record to release immediately. Cropper told the record executive, "We don't have anything that's finished. Everything is raw and in the can." Atlantic Records insisted. So Cropper, even though had a difficult time doing the final mix on the track because of Otis's death, decided to release Sittin' on the Dock of the Bay. About 3 months later, on March 16, 1968, Sittin' on the Dock of the Bay reached number one on the Billboard charts and became Redding's posthumous signature song.
RTL.
Oh man, all the classics in the second hour of the show on a Thursday, which is Throwback Thursday. Brian Adams, Summer of 69. Before that, obviously, we played Otis Redding, Sitting on the Dock of the Bay. What an interesting little piece, how that song actually came about. And sad that he never actually got to hear it in its entirety, the way it was released, and see it go up to number one. Oh, man. I'll tell you what. Very sad. Real loss for music in general, for the world. And he died at 26 and only really got his real break at the age of 23, so it was a very short-lived career. In such a short amount of time, he made such a big difference in the way music is consumed and really brought soul to life. So yeah, absolute tragedy, but we remember him fondly and appreciate his music today still. Right, we're going to get into your Power Play trivia in just a second. The question I asked you is, where does Heineken come from? Which country? And I got a couple of correct answers in so far as well. Also, still taking your burning topic comments. Where were you and what were you doing at when 9/11 happened? What was up? What were you doing? I remember very, very clearly where I was and what I was doing at that time. So send me your comments via voice notes on 064-134-0020. And I'll play the comments back in a little bit.
Caban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Caban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.caban.co.za for more information. Caban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTL SA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTL SA.
Time to test your knowledge with power.
Just
here, guys.
1981. You're listening to RTLSA.
Time to test your knowledge with Power Play Trivia.
Now that I play the sting in the right place, your Power Play Trivia brought to you by Bev Miller. Today's question, where does Heineken originate from? And the correct answer was, in fact, the Netherlands. Bev, Cheryl, Marius all get in there, and Lauren eventually get in there. But it is indeed the Netherlands.
On February 15, 1864, the mother of 22-year-old Gerard Heineken bought him the Haystack Brewery in Amsterdam in the Netherlands. The Haystack brand had been sold since 1592, but the Dutch beer market was struggling when the brewery was purchased by the Heinekens. The first Heineken brand beer was brewed in 1873 after a special yeast was developed for the brand. By 1875, they become the biggest beer exporter in France. After World War I, the company focused primarily on exports. Just 3 days after Prohibition ended in the United States, the first shipment of Heineken beer was delivered to the country, and it's been a favorite brand ever since. Heineken has grown to become a truly global brand and is currently the second largest brewer in the world, behind Anheuser-Busch. In 2014, Heineken celebrated their 150th anniversary, and it doesn't look like this multi-billion dollar company is going anywhere anytime soon.
RTLSA.
Throwing back to the extreme this Thursday, Salt and Pepper Pusher. Before that, Tracy Chapman talking about Revolution and one of Adam Lambert's first singles, If I Had You, on RTLSA. Loving it. Throwback Thursday. It's a burning topic on the other side of this.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
Playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Bass music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining.
RTLSA.
You're listening to RTLSA.
Have your say now. It's the burning topic.
I seem to be one of the very few people in the world that remember where they were and what they were doing on the 11th of September 2001, roughly around about 4 PM, somewhere around there. But Lauren does. So let's hear what Lauren had to say.
Morning, burning topic. For the 9/11, I was at home. I remember I lived in Morningside, in Kensington Flats, and my son was at Morningside Primary, and I just brought him back from school, just made him a sandwich, and we sat down, and I put the news on, and wham, I think it wasn't even 5 minutes. And I just started screaming, and my son kept asking me, "Mom, what's going on? Mom, what's going on?" And that's basically where it started. I was flabbergasted. I just held my son And we just watched, and I didn't say a word. I just said, it's fine, my boy, don't look. Yeah, it was horrific, absolutely horrific.
It is a small world, because you know what, Lauren? I also lived in Kensington Heights at one point in Morningside. Wow, I didn't know that. Sure, okay, cool. But yeah, no, I wasn't in Kensington at that point on that day. I remember I was still studying, and part of my practical, I was working in a restaurant, and I'd been at home because I had to work the night shift, and so I only went in for my shift at around about 4 PM and was oblivious to what was going on. And when I walked into the restaurant, everybody was in the bar. Literally, when I say everybody, from customers to waiters to kitchen staff, everybody was standing in the bar around the television. And I walked into this restaurant, oblivious to what was going on, and everybody's in the bar, and I'm like, what could be going on? And needless to say, we didn't do a hell of a lot of trading or any work for quite a while that evening, because we were glued to the television and what was going on. And I'll never forget it as long as I live, because it was almost surreal. You couldn't actually fathom that this was even possible at that point. And that's why I say it was a moment in the world that changed the world, not just America, but the world in an instant. It was insane. And you know, obviously 3,000 lives lost that day, and so many more over the next 20 years. So it was all a sad story, but I'll never forget it and where I was. And walking into the restaurant and just like thinking, what the hell is going on? It was rather strange.
RTL.
Tom Grennan, a little bit of love before that. Sam Smith and Normani and Dancing with a Stranger on RTLSA. That's where we're going to leave the show for today. We'll be back tomorrow with Bad Joke Friday, so make sure you don't miss that. It's going to be epic, baby. And of course, Noel's Friday mix as well, so that's going to be cool. If you are not busy this afternoon and around about 5 o'clock, we are going to be doing a live interview with Eddie Kramer on sacommuter.co.za. We are doing it, myself and Janine are going to be doing it together with Eddie Kramer. It's going to be very cool this afternoon. If you do miss it, however, this afternoon, I will be cutting it up and playing it back on Throwback Thursday next week. Who is Eddie Kramer, you may ask? One of the most world-renowned producers, has worked with the likes of Jimi Hendrix, The Kinks, Eric Clapton, and many, many more. South African-born, and made big waves across the world with his production skills and stuff like that. So go to sacommuter.co.za this afternoon at 5 p.m. and catch us live with that interview. Otherwise, I'll bring it to you next Thursday. Be cool, be safe, remember what I always say, if it bugs you, deal with it. Playing out with some Cage the Elephant, Ain't No Rest for the Wicked, baby. Love ya!
Caban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Caban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.caban.co.za for more information. Caban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
Here you go.
This was really
1981. You're listening to RTLSA.
I want to be on lockdown with Noel Johnson.
You are listening to.
You're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're going to party it up listening to Noel Johnson.
As I was saying, you're listening to my mate, Noel Johnson.